My name's Casey McKinley, and I'm a race car driver by birth. When I was born, my parents had bought an old farm on Old Neal Way, just east of a town called Grapeseed in Blaine County. It was here growing up as a kid I had remembered my dad always working on race cars, and old rare ones that remind me of the Bonnie and Clyde car, a favorite movie of his he would always get me to watch with him. I remember night after night him working on cars at the auto shed, and the smell of the gas and oil on his clothes. I would always be looking at the hot rod magazines he would leave scattered all over the through the house, and the car parts and boxes from places I'd never even heard of. I especially remember the very first time I had ever seen my dad race. All the excitement that was going on around me, the chrome and the glitter that was shining so brightly in the night. I remember the look on his face and his stern eyes as he gripped the steering wheel of the fastest horse-powered racing machine I had ever seen. Through the years, I was excited to see him race against the Midnight Club the most, and I knew back then it wouldn't be very long before I also would become a rebel with a cause. It had become widely known throughout the racing world in Los Santos that all the illegal races at the airport were run through a couple of corrupt security guards, keeping a strict rule that the entry fee of $200,000 was to be paid up front before the race and given to the winner minus their service charges. Bribing them to store your car in the hangar was always a good way to keep the cops from being alerted and busting your ass before you could even make it to the airstrip. They had informed me that the driver from the Midnight Club was here and was outside at the airstrip ready and waiting for me to show up to start the race. The midnight run at the airport was always my least favorite spot to race. It could always be counted on that I would run into some type of resistance, but for the 200,000 for less than 100 seconds was something I, like my dad, would never say no to, no matter what the risk.
You're a brave man to face me. There's two thumbs up for showing up.
cops in Los Santos were relentlessly brutal when it came to illegal racing at the airport. In the past, I had always had an escape route planned in case of trouble, but this time I didn't seem so lucky. LSPD and SWAT had come in at me so much faster than in previous years, making my reaction time to escape hard to do. And this time, you could literally say I had backed myself into a corner. And the only way out of this mess isn't looking good. Matter of fact, any way out alive seems like a slim chance of happening. With ammo running low fast, I knew it would only be a matter of minutes before SWAT would rush in, and yet all I can think of is the stories of car chases my dad would talk about back in his whiskey bootlegging days. Fascinating stories of excitement. He said living on the edge means driving into a hurricane at 160 miles an hour, but for me, it's been being chased by the cops for the last 15 years, and until now, I've never felt like this was my last day.
Child arrived just the other day. He came to the world in the usual way, but there were planes to catch and bills to pay. He learned to walk while I was away, and he was talking for I knew it. And as he grew, he'd say, I'm gonna be like you, Dad. You know I'm gonna be like you. And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue. My son turned 10 just the other day. He said, thanks for the ball, Dad. Come on, let's play. Can you teach me to throw? I said, not today. I got a lot to do. He said, that's okay. And he walked away, but his smile never dimmed. It said, I'm gonna be like him. Yeah, you know I'm gonna be.